The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Dosto, we had promised you that we will be making a video series about the blood tests. All the blood tests, medical tests, which you need to understand, which you should know about. And that's why we are starting today's first blood test series with complete blood count, right? CBC. What is CBC? What tests are included in this CBC? The first video will be dedicated to this. So let's see, what is it? And as always, all our videos are directly referenced from the US National Medical Library, so you can trust the information given in these videos. So what is a CBC? CBC is basically complete blood count, or in which your blood is tested for various different parts of your blood is tested. Example, your red blood cells. Red blood cells are the cells which carry oxygen from your, which carry oxygen after taking from the lungs to all your body, right? Red blood cells are tested for their size, their number, their internal hemoglobin concentration, volume, corpuscular volume, how much volume they have, everything is tested, right? These size shapes are tested. Then white blood cells are tested. White blood cells are the fighting cells which fight infections, right? There are five major types of white blood cells in your body, and CBC basically measures the total number of white blood cells and the individual number of all these five different types of white blood cells. And in this CBC, complete blood count, code differential, that differential count is this, the ingredient, the different numbers of those five ingredients or five individual white blood cells, each type of white blood cells, right? Then there are, in these five type, there are lymphocytes, neutrophils, there are monocytes, there are eosinophils, and there are other one more type is there, macrophages, I think. So that's one thing. Then there is platelet counts. Platelet count, which is platelets are the cells which help your blood to clot and to stop bleeding. So the quantity of these platelets in your blood is counted. Hemoglobin level is counted, which is present in the red blood cells. This is a protein that basically carries the oxygen, which is coming from the lungs to the rest of the body. That the concentration of hemoglobin is measured. Hematocrit is also measured. Hematocrit is basically the measurement of how much blood is made up of red blood cells, right? How much quantity, how much part of the blood is red blood cells, that is the hematocrit. So a complete blood count can also indicate measures of chemicals and other substances which are present in your blood, and the result can give your doctor a very, very important information about your overall health and as well as your risk of certain diseases, right? See, this test can be used on the initial test line for many diseases, including all the infections, even blood anemias, if you have any disorder related to immune system, any blood diseases or cancers, etc., etc. Almost every time complete blood count is always done. But how is it done? Obviously, your blood is taken and it's tested. So do you need to prepare for the test? No, you don't need any preparation for the test. You don't need an empty stomach. You don't need to don't need to have a empty bowel or any kind of preparation for this test. Is there any risk at this test? See, there is a very little risk of doing any blood test. You will have a slight pain because of the needle. You might have a bruising at the spot of the needle, and most of the time it goes away very quickly, right? Now what do these test results mean, right? A CBC counts, basically they count the cell and measures the level of different substances in your blood, and there are many, many reasons the level of these can actually fall outside the normal range. For example, if there is an abnormal red blood cell count, or there is an abnormal hemoglobin, or even the hematocrit levels, it can indicate anemia, it can indicate iron deficiency, or even heart disease in these circumstances, right? White blood cells counts, if they are less, then that can indicate an autoimmune disease, a bone marrow problem, or even cancer, right? And a very high white blood cell count can indicate infection or a reaction to something, some medicine or some kind of allergic reaction to something, right? Inflammation, basically. So there are similar interpretation of this CBCs, and if any of these levels are abnormal, it does not necessarily indicate that a medical problem needing in treatment or is there, right? It's not necessary. Sometimes diets, some physical activity levels, some ongoing medicines, women's menstrual cycle, and even other considerations can affect the results, right? So you need to talk to a physician, doctor, and see whether your results have any clinical significance or not. And what else do you need to do? See, this is only a tool. Complete blood count, CBC, is a tool in the hands of your doctor to actually assess and learn more about your body. Along with this, your doctor needs your medical history, your symptoms, and many other factors, your lifestyle, to actually come to a diagnosis of what is a problem in you. And then only when there is a diagnosis, then only you can have a treatment, right? Remember, treatment is done for diseases, not for tests. Right, so this is an overall overview of complete blood count, CBC, and we will be discussing normal CBC and abnormal CBCs in further details in upcoming videos. Don't forget to watch those videos and don't forget to share this video. I'm Dr. Paramjit, you're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected and stay healthy.